The Screams Left Unheard by Lauren Willaredt. Jenny and her younger sister, Kate, were sitting at the kitchen table carving jack-o'-lanterns. Jenny was trying to carve a scary face, and Kate was making a mess with the pumpkin goop. It was in her dark brown hair and all over the kitchen. She enjoyed disobeying her sister and making messes. Kate picked up a handful of pumpkin goop and flung it at Jenny, which hit her pumpkin and knocked it off the table.
"Kate!"
Jenny yelled, picking her jack-o'-lantern off the floor.
"Sorry,"
Kate said, laughing so hard she was almost crying. Jenny let out a sigh, desperate to return order to the kitchen. "Stop goofing off. You need to finish your pumpkin." Kate threw the goop away and said, disappointed, "All right. I just don't get why you like everything to be all neat and clean." When they were done carving their pumpkins, they went outside to put them on the porch. Kate had carved an odd face with a big mouth and silly eyes. Jenny had carved a terrifying scowl with an angry expression. Jenny took the top of her jack-o'-lantern and placed a candle inside. Like a switch that was flipped, the pumpkin began to grow and grow until it was bigger than the house. Its already scary face became more horrific as the sisters watched in absolute terror. Jenny and Kate let out a scream. The pumpkin, with its terrifying scowl and glowing eyes, let out a laugh. The laugh made Jenny's skin crawl and sent shivers up her spine. The jack-o'-lantern opened its mouth and sucked in the sisters. In an instant, they were falling in a pit of darkness. Kate's screams were swept away, and Jenny yelled for help. There was nobody to hear them. Nobody but themselves. They were alone in the darkness, falling for what seemed like an eternity. Jenny hit the ground hard. She kept her eyes closed, and her whole body hurt. She heard a cry next to her.
"Kate!"
Jenny screamed and sat straight up. She looked around and saw Kate lying on the ground next to her.
"Kate!
Kate!" Jenny whispered and poked her, trying to wake her up. Kate sat up.
"What happened?"
she groaned.
I'm not sure," replied Jenny. "I think our jack-o'-lantern just ate us."
Jenny looked around and she was surrounded by darkness.
"What's that?" Kate said,
pointing into the darkness. Jenny squinted her eyes and could see a red light in the distance. She helped Kate up, held her hand, and started walking toward the light. They walked slowly as they couldn't see what was around them. They approached a small, dark hut with a red porch light.
"What do you think lives here?" Kate asked.
I don't... Jenny started. Suddenly, the door to the shack slowly opened. The girls peered inside and saw nobody inside.
"Let's go in," Kate said,
marching up the porch steps.
"No,"
Jenny replied. She grabbed Kate by the arm.
"We don't know where we are, and we don't know what's in there. Why do you always have such crazy ideas?"
"Okay, Miss Bossy, you can be boring, but I'm going in." Kate walked through the door, turned around, and smiled at Jenny.
"See,"
she giggled, "nothing happened."
And the door slammed shut.
"Kate!"
Jenny screamed and ran to the door, but the hut had disappeared, with Kate inside.
It was gone.
Jenny was aghast. She walked forward to the spot where the hut once stood, feeling a tremendous sense of loss, desperation, and confusion. In the darkness, she tripped over something. She knelt down and searched the area for what she had stumbled over. She felt something cold and flat like a stone. She heard an eerie whisper,
"Push!"
Jenny, still stunned and worried about her sister, did as she was told. The whole dark void around her collapsed. And there was nothing. There was nothing around her. No color, no light, no sound. "Open your eyes, stupid," Jenny heard the voice say. She opened her eyes and saw what appeared to be another void. Except unlike the last one, this one was white. It had a giant portal that stood between her and Kate.
"Kate! Kate, what are you doing? What if that house was dangerous? You could have been hurt,"
Jenny said, angry. Kate let out an evil giggle, a giggle that did not belong to Kate. Jenny studied her, realized that Kate didn't look like Kate. This was not her sister. This imposter had Kate's dark hair, but her eyes were red, and her smile was menacing. Oh, don't worry about me.
But guess what? The imposter said. I found a way out. Come with me through that portal, and everything will be fine.
The imposter's grin grew more evil.
Go ahead.
Jenny thought over the possibilities and realized only bad choices existed. But she figured going through the portal was likely her only way to find the real Kate. So she reluctantly entered the portal. In a flash, Jenny was in a forest ruled by Kate's imposter, the Forest of Forgotten Screams. Jenny turned around and faced the imposter. The imposter transformed into her true form, a huge dark monster with giant black wings and horns. Her face became nothing but a skull, and she was surrounded by dark clouds. She levitated off the ground and cackled. Jenny screamed and ran, tearing through the forest, stumbling over tree roots, struggling to breathe. The monster flew behind her quickly, throwing dark clouds of magic at her. Every cloud that hit the ground shook the earth and sent Jenny flying up in the air. Then she would land, stumble, and keep running. Jenny didn't know exactly where she was going, but she knew she had to survive the monster and had to find Kate. Finally, one of the clouds of magic hit the ground behind her, shooting her straight into the sky. This time, she hit the ground hard and couldn't recover. Her pain was intense. "You're mine now," the terrifying monster said with the most evil, menacing grin Jenny had ever seen. It levitated Jenny to eye level.
"Nobody ever escapes me."
The monster circled Jenny, who was still suspended. "Not in my billion years of existence has anyone ever escaped, and no one ever will." She slammed Jenny into the ground and lifted her up again.
"You see, silly mortal?
I am the servant of the Pumpkin Lord. For almost 1,000 years I have been waiting for someone to summon him again." Once again, she slammed Jenny down, torturing her.
"You have summoned his presence. You carved his face into your pumpkin and released him. You will be our prisoner, like your silly little sister. You will be tortured for eternity, and I will finally get to worship the Pumpkin Lord once again."
In a final act of desperation, Jenny released one final scream. It sounded as if 1,000 tortured souls exclaimed at once. Miraculously, her scream released her from the levitated position, and she was running once again. Somehow, she found her way back to the dark hut. That's where she saw Kate, sitting quietly in a chair right behind the Pumpkin Lord, clearly under his control.
"You have released me," its voice boomed. "Out of all the pumpkins carved in the last 1,000 years, you have finally carved my face to give me life once again. In return, I shall release you. I have no use for you. You may return to reality."
"Wait, Kate's coming too, right?"
Jenny asked, panicked.
"No, Kate has failed. She is to stay here with me. She will be tortured for the next 1,000 years, answered the Pumpkin Lord.
"No, you can't do this, please," said Jenny.
"Jenny," Kate said, "just go. It's either you or me. I'm doomed." With that, Jenny's pumpkin grew the size of a house again and sucked her in. Then it went dark. Once more, she fell into nothingness. Jenny awoke in her room. She jumped up and sprinted downstairs. She ran to her parents.
"Is she here? Is Kate okay?" she shouted.
Her mom looked confused.
"Jenny, who is Kate?" "Kate, my sister," shouted Jenny, growing more and more terrified.
"Jenny, you're an only child," said her mom with a laugh. Jenny ran around the house looking for any evidence of Kate, but she found nothing. She ran outside to find their jack-o'-lanterns, but neither were there. Jenny knelt down and stared at her house, aghast and heartbroken. Kate would forever be prisoner of the pumpkin lord Jenny had released. She looked to the sky and tried to scream, but no sound emerged. Her scream was the silence of an infinite sadness. The end.